What's up? Today's day 251. Make it Songbringer. Yesterday I was working on this level entrance. Boogie! What up, yo? So here's that level entrance. I kinda gotta hack it. It's not all hooked up completely yet. You can see there's no actual collision tiles for where you're actually supposed to use the cup, but you can use the cup as soon as he puts the sword away. How you doing today, Boogie? Put your sword away. You know you want to. Sorry, I might have might be echoing some sound there. Sorry if that's the case. There. Okay, so let's use the cup. I love that. I had so much fun making that art. Yeah, all right. Doing good? Nice. Right on. Awesome. So today I'm working on the spirit guide. Sort of, this is how you're going to find these fountains, right? Your spirit guide is the guy, he's this guy, the guy with the horns. Let's get him open up. The guy from the, this guy right here. I guess this horn guy right here. I'm not sure what his name is yet. He's a character. It's a very important character in the game. I'm not going to reveal too much about him. But, he's also sort of a spirit. Like, he's this guy you see whenever you first start taking the cactuses, you start seeing him. And then you follow him to these fountains. What up, Pedro? Canada's amazing! What up, y'all? So let's get this guy open. What's his name again? I think he's called Akiyu for now. Yeah, here we go. Here, Akiyu. So I'm going to work on this guy, an actual walking animation, so we can see him eat the cactus, see this guy, and he kind of guides you towards the first level. Oh no, infinite buffering of doom. What's up, Big Mac Dev? It's going really good, man. Yeah, I got 4 new enemies done this week, and now I'm working on this second dungeon here. If you don't think of anything, his name should be Ralph. Nice. Ralph. It's like very non-spirity. I like it. But Big Mac, let me show you. I'll show you again the this other dungeon entrance. Hold on, is there any enemies around I could show you that are new? These guys are not new. There's 4 new enemies. There's a tentacle. There's a porcupine, there's a bouncing ball thing, and there's this elephant / anteater thing. And they all appear to be in other areas. Big Mac, if you haven't seen, there's also diagonal movement now, and there's 4 different buttons you can use. So instead of 2 buttons, you got 4, which I think is going to be very important for this game. Now that there's starting to be a lot more items, and eventually there's going to be even more items, so you're going to need to have more than just 2 accessible. Wow, we're not even lucking out at all finding these enemies. Here's some of them. The ball guys. Oh, here we go. Here's the elephant guys. They're so cute. I don't even want to hurt them. But I guess you don't really technically have to hurt them. I'll show you this entrance too. Oh yeah, damn. And so yesterday I'm working on this new entrance. This is a new dungeon type. Where you why is my cursor in the middle of the screen? You get this red cup. See, the red cup item is this thing. It's just a stupid red cup. But it's not. It's actually one of the most important items in the game. It allows you access to these sort of, they're sort of secret dungeons. Or optional dungeons, really, more of an accurate word. But, you use your cup, you drink from a fountain, it's poison, you fall asleep, or you get poisoned, or whatever, and you wake up inside this dungeon. And I'm thinking Jib's not even gonna be inside, you're not even gonna have Jib with you during these dungeons. So, but yeah, you have to fight your way out, you gain some abilities, you have your spirit guide in there and stuff, so that's kind of what I'm working on, is getting that hooked up. What up, Tom? Welcome. Welcome to the stream. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is keep on working on the, I'm going to start working on the spirit guide. All I have so far is this picture of him so far. Totally. So this guy, let's get him, I'm going to draw this guy from the east first, maybe south, maybe I'll do south. Yeah, I'll turn him around and draw him from the south first. I guess for now I'm calling him a Kiyu, Ralph, perhaps. I could rename this guy, so if you guys have ideas for naming this guy, feel free to shout out. Okay, so let's do the idol south. Let's give him a gray background. All right. He's like an owl right now or something. He twists his head around. I'm just taking a couple of these colors to make a palette. Kind of wondering what he's gonna have on underneath all this, right? What is he actually wearing? Does he have like armor on underneath this robe, cloak thing, or what? So, color scheme wise, I think he's okay. I'm trying to decide if he should have armor or clothes on underneath that. Thanks for following. Let's play around with a different color for these for his eyes. It's kind of interesting. What up, Alex Pita? How's it going, man? I'm drawing this spirit guide guy. He's going to guide you when you start eating the cactuses. He guides you to these special secret worlds, the optional dungeons. I'm gonna play around with a completely different hue. Maybe this guy actually changes hues. Oh, Quasi. I don't know how to say your name, right? Tell me if you want me to pronounce your name different, but that's awesome, dude. I'm glad you're reading it. I'm glad you're thankful, and I hope it helps. I really, really hope that article helps to just, put game developers on the right path to prove if their game is going to make money, or that people will buy the game, so you don't have to fail hard. 'Cause I've failed hard many times and I don't ever want to fail again hard. So yeah, I stream pretty much every day, 5 to 7 days a week, just about this time every day. So nice. Right on. Nug Troll. Cool. I'm glad you guys all read that. That's awesome. Thanks for reading it. And like, once again, the main point of that article is to help. So I hope this idea spreads throughout the whole concept is, you guys already got the concepts, just that you to prove your game before you spend the time making it. So I hope that concept kind of gets spread throughout the indie game development scene so that there's less failure, or at least if there is failure, you know kind of why, and you can just turn it into success however you want, whatever that is, whatever success means for you. So anyways, I'm gonna play with some hue. I'm not sure if this brown hue works, right? If, especially if he's got some sort of like earthy, like he's got skins on or something, like some kind of animal skins. But maybe because it's kind of a psychedelic character, he's meant to be your spirit guide and all that. So maybe I'll play with some psychedelic colors. Let's see. Alrighty, that's kind of interesting right there. Sort of a turning it to be red. This pinkish purple is kind of weird. Whoa. Now that's really weird. Oh, Letality, yeah. How you doing, man? I'm doing good. He's wearing dye. Tie-dye. Oh, tie-dye color, yeah. Tie-dye color might actually be. Oh my God. That's actually a funny idea. Oh my God, I kind of want to try that. I kind of want to try him as tie-dyed. Blue, kind of boring. I don't know why the blue is so boring. Cyan, kind of weird. Green, ooh, bright green is really weird. Yeah, okay. Let's try an experiment with totally with them wearing tie-dye. This is not what I intended from the beginning, but it might look cool. This faded tie-dye is kind of right what I was imagining. What's up, JFK? High five, man. And this other one too is kind of interesting, but it's way more saturated. So I'm not sure if this will work as well with the theme and everything, but let's copy that one too. It's for color reference. Okay, and I'm gonna sample a couple of these colors. Or maybe I'll just shrink it all down. So if you just joined the stream, I'm working on this concept where you get this red cup, you get a red party cup, and I'm not sure where you'll find it in the game, but you take the red cup and you go. If you find a certain area in the overworld, you can drink from a fountain using your red cup, and drinking from the fountain takes you to a secret slash optional dungeon where. You meet this guy, you meet the spirit guide, and actually the spirit guide kind of guides you there, and then you gain abilities by fighting with the him. You actually fight this guy, and then you have to kind of fight your way out of the dungeon, fighting mobs of crazy enemies and stuff. So, what's up, Rocket Bunny? Yeah, the red cup. If you haven't seen, let me show you guys what it looks like. It actually has turned out really great. I had a lot of fun animating this yesterday. It took all day, but so worth it. I mean, I wasn't even concerned about time. It was so enjoyable to make this animation. So it's not all hooked up yet. There's no collision boxes or anything for any of this stuff. So just gotta wait for him to put away his sword, and we can drink from the fountain, and he falls over, and it doesn't really go to the level yet. But that's kind of what happens. So at this point, it would fade out, and you'd wake up inside the optional dungeon. Nice, Lethality. Good for you, man. Lighter Thief, what's up? How you doing, Thief? So right now, I'm playing with the spirit guide guy, and Boogie brought up the idea of maybe making him tie-dye, and I'm like, maybe he should be tie-dyed. Yeah, what's up, man? I saw your art. I like the deep color of the water you had actually, but I agreed with pretty much everyone else that maybe a tad bit lighter would look good. You mean Ralph is 7-Eleven? My God, that's funny. Yeah, I'm doing great, man. I'm really doing so awesome. It's great to be making a video game. It's great to be doing all this. And yeah, it's just good to do what I love. I love doing this. So this is a total experiment. I don't know. I got a backup copy of this guy, but so I'm gonna try and do a tie-dyed version of this guy and see if he looks stupid or if he looks okay or what. Yeah. Yeah, he's the one from the mock-up. Yep. So this is I don't know what his name is yet, or even if he's gonna look exactly like that, but he's your spirit guide, and he's sort of your enemy, and he's sort of your friend. And I don't know. I'm not exactly sure what he'll be, but he's gonna be something crazy and exciting for sure. I don't know. I don't know about these colors. This might be over the top. Have I put her in? Technically, yes. Yeah, I had her in there for a minute where you could play as her. But to actually see it, so I'm kind of up on the fence as how you will actually play her. Will she be a second player character only? Will she have limited abilities, or will she have all the exact same abilities as the main hero and be sort of like an option where you can play as her or play as him? So I'm up in the air as far as how she'll play in the game, but she's gonna be in there somehow. She might be an NPC or a character that you meet, or she might actually be a fully playable character. We'll see. For sure, Jib is gonna be playable as the second player, so it'll be local. If you want to play local co-op, you can have one of your friends play as Jib, so you can scan enemies and do stuff. But yeah, second player E kind of things. Support character, basically. Vendable. Yeah, the well's kind of, it's not totally finished, but it is, it's finished enough so you can drink from it. Yeah, but there's no collision boxes. I haven't done much of the mechanics at all for this, so. That's basically, yeah. So imagine it fades out, you wake up in the secret dungeon. Yeah, see, I don't know. I don't know exactly how that'll play out. Hello, Simprasovic. Thanks, Tom Nook. Cheers, man. So yeah, I'm experimenting with this guy. I'm just going to experiment and totally try him with tie-dye on. I have no idea what this is going to look like, so but it might be fun. It's already fun. That's for sure. Yeah, it was supposed to be very narrow, a hexagon shape. It wasn't supposed to be a circle shape. You can see, yeah, I get you. I get what you're saying there, though. Let me take a look at that. All right, Rocket Bunny, see you, man. Yeah, I might need to make it deeper, actually. Yeah, I'm always making that mistake. I'm always making it a little bit too platformery. So yeah, I'll work on that. Get a deeper purple for the deep purple part or pink. Thanks for always reminding me of that. Oh yeah, big time difference. I hear you. Where are you at? What time zone are you in? So the thing about this guy is you eat these well you either eat cactuses or you drink from the fountain or whatever, you trip out. So that's kind of the concept behind this guy, is that you're in a very psychedelic state whenever you're meeting with this guy or whatever. So that's why I'm trying him out with the psychedelic colors to see if it's even anywhere near looks right. Oh yeah. UTC, which one's UTC? Oh, Universal. Okay, so Central European time is like, is that Central European time then? UTC plus one? Yeah, a lot of you guys, I know a lot of you guys are around there. Nice, triple monitor, wow. For you it's Eastern time? Yeah, nice, right on. Cool. For me, it's like 2 p.m. So I'm kind of streaming as early as I can for in my time zone. Wow, that actually looks kind of neat. Guy actually looks like this. It'd be so funny. I do enjoy a good laugh, that's for sure. Wow, this is getting interesting. It's only 11 in the UK, nice. So, the Bob Ross stream is still going on. Anybody been watching that? People are still hyped. Crazy hyped. What's up, Malak Realak? Is there a cheaper alternative? Yeah, of course there is GIMP. There's also, it depends on your platform. But there's also, if you're on Mac, there's Pixelmator. And then there's a bunch of great ones like, so there's Pixelmator. Oh, is Pixelmator on other platforms now? Oh, it's just iOS. One in a million games end up with that version of him. What's up with my Command C? So there's that, and then there's also, I've heard great things about Pixel Edit. What do you use, Lighter Thief? I think, don't you use Photoshop? There's Pixel Edit. Yeah, right? If she's gonna be, yeah. It's, well, the thing is, that's cash it. That's kind of my question is like, I'm really kind of on the fence whether she's a fully functional player. As in all the same abilities as the hero, like she has a sword, she can use the bombs, she can use everything. Or is she just a support character where she only has specific abilities that only she can do? Like maybe she has a gun, or maybe she has specific abilities just for her. So I'm not quite sure. The real focus of this game is on the single player elements. That's really, if this game does anything right, I really want it to be a good single player game, you know? So. And saying that, that's the most important thing, I think. You know, if it's a great single player game, I'm not really so concerned that it's an awesome co-op game. But having it being able to play co-op as well would be pretty neat, you know. And if that's done well, of course, that's always a good thing. Have I tried Affinity Photo? No, I haven't. Nice. Affinity Photo? What's that one? Is it good for painting? Looks like it is. I mean, it looks like it's a great photo editing software, but is it good painting software? Looks like they did an amazing job marketing it, that's for sure. So sorry man, I don't know any good Java resources. I don't program in Java myself, so I don't really know. But there might be some other people here on the stream that know some good Java resources. I don't know. Oh yeah. There you go, objects first with Java. What's is that ASE sprite? Yeah, I've seen this one. Nice. I love seeing these this old school type of UI. Oh, cool. Onion skinning? Rad. So I'm playing around with trying some psychedelic colors for this guy because he's very psychedelic. So far, it actually kind of looks cool. Maybe when you go into the dungeon, into this secret dungeon, he actually looks like this. Wow. Okay. I like this. Let's try another version of him. Oh wait. Let's play around a little bit with him and make him look cooler. Like we can add a nice highlight to the top of him. Coco Studio? Nah, sorry, I haven't tried that yet. Nice, man. This just makes me laugh just thinking about this guy being like this. Nice. Idea, right? If you're programming in Java too much, you'll grow a tie. I haven't programmed in Java too much, so I don't know, but that sounds really funny. All right, so the ultimate test of anything you make in a game is to put it in the game and then see if it works right with the lighting and the existing stuff in the game. That's why you see a lot of artists, they'll actually work on a mock-up image with the existing game already in it, but I just find it quicker to throw things right in the game. So anyways, I'm gonna try and put this guy in the game and see if he looks right in the overworld as all psychedelic, because maybe not, maybe he won't look good, and we actually need to, this psychedelic version of him only appears inside the psychedelic dungeon or whatever. But yeah, let's just see how it looks. So let's get these palettes and put them on a different layer. Can you do Java and Xcode? Can you? I don't know. I don't know if Xcode has all I don't know. I wish I knew that, man. Wait a minute. I think I got some. Hold on, I can try it. 'Cause I think I got an Android, the Android version here, and I think there's got to be at least one Java file in here. Yeah. Oh yeah, look, it does syntax highlight Java. I don't know if it compiles Java though. So, but at least it does do syntax highlighting. That's kind of cool. Oh, true. Yeah, you could definitely do this. Xcode does have, you can build using external tools with Xcode. So all you would do, right? You could go and you would do like this. You'd go run script. You do a script run. Right, for your a run, you'd add a run script phase, so you can actually add another phase to your build here, right? So if you're following along, this is just in projects. Oh, you go here to this plus icon, you go to one of your targets, so you probably add another target for your Android, right? And then you just go plus to add a new run script phase, and then you would have no, you wouldn't compile any sources, you'd have nothing here, you would just run your make script that would run all your Java tools. Your Java compile here. So yeah, that's totally possible in Xcode. You could use it as an IDE essentially, and you just wouldn't be using its Clang compiler or anything. All right, so now I'm gonna try and get this guy hooked up in the game, see if he looks anywhere near right. Letality, yeah, you've been getting a bunch of suggestions here for Java. So read back through the chat log. Yeah. Oh, the name of the book again. There you go. Thanks, Tom. Okay, so let's make an NPC profile for this guy. Like, I guess we could base it on the squirrel. The squirrel is really squirrely, but it'll do. All right, and once again, I'm totally taking suggestions for the name of this guy. Boogie has suggested Ralph. I had his name as Akiyu for now. I don't know if that's, I don't know about that name. But anyways, he's either gonna look like this, like the brown sort of, or he's gonna look like this. I'm not sure. But if you have any ideas for what you want this guy to be named, definitely shout them out, and I will take them in consideration. So for now, let's call him a Kiyu for this file here. Collision neutral, that's okay. 10 by, no, more like like 12 or so, 14 even. This guy's pretty wide. His idol. We get rid of all of his behavior for now. All right, the next thing would be to put him somewhere. So there's a part where I generate a squirrel. I'll just do it right around there. All right, create NPCs. Yes. Okay, so let's create a squirrel as well as this guy. And we'll put them at the top of the screen for now. He has input, he has AI. Some move component. You know what? I shouldn't even be doing it this way, but oh well, we did it this way for now. Nice, Letter Thief. I'm glad. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for saying that. I'm so appreciative that that so many people have said thank you. It's great. And I really do hope it helps. I hope it oh my God, he's definitely way too psychedelic colored for now. Or I mean, I think. Is he? Maybe if he was desaturated. So funny. Let's move him a little lower too. Right? He's like a sore thumb. Wow. That better? Cool. Stream. You don't even care. Yeah. You love it? An aura. That's interesting. Yes, Tom Nook, Super Brothers is definitely a huge influence on this game. So is Crawl, like visually. You know, of course, this game is purely inspired, pretty much inspired by The Legend of Zelda, as far as gameplay goes, but Super Brothers Sword and Sorcery, definitely a big influence on the art. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, let's try an aura. I'm gonna try a little bit of desaturation here, too. So we'll try an aura with like some Gaussian blur. Oh my God. With the cool shader, this might actually work. Pulsating, yeah, we could do that. Another layer. I was thinking a cool shader would be neat if it did some sort of like it was looked like it was undulating. And I kind of want to do that for a lot of the things in the secret dungeon, so. Ah, that does give him that does somehow make him fit a little bit better, having an aura. Let's try and pump that aura up even. Yes, definitely. Yeah, his role, I don't want to give away too much of his role, but well, yeah, sorry, I won't give away his story, but I will tell you his role at first in the game. When you take the cactuses, right? Does he? That might be the screen moving a little bit. You eat the cactuses and he becomes your spirit guide. So you start to see him out of your corner of your eye. Like he'll be on the edge of the screen or whatever when you eat the cactus. So like if I eat a cactus, he would be once you eat the cactus, you'd see him on the edge of the screen. He'd just be walking away. And so he's always kind of guiding you towards the secret dungeons or the fountains. So he was on this screen, he would be at the top of these stairs, like guiding you up to this point right here where you can drink from the fountain and then you discover him inside the dungeon. So he's sort of a spirit guide. He's also sort of a teacher for you. He teaches you to use your own spirit or chi powers, your bio energy powers. So that's how you get a bunch of you get this, not the charge. Oh, let's give the player the other one. Yeah, the screen. Charge? What's the other one? Dash? This one is also unfinished. But this is one of the abilities you'll gain in the secret dungeon from him, basically. Oops. Oh, you gotta have your sword out for that one. But yeah, this is one of the abilities you'll get. You can like dash forward really quick. And it also attacks, so you'll hurt enemies while you're dashing forward. So, but yeah, it's kind of like a chi power, like some kind of like, it's sort of not really technology, it's just based on your actual, it's like a mystical power, sort of. Maybe. Gonna try one more layer. Yeah, I still think he's a bit too much. He's just a bit too much for the overworld. So I think in the overworld he's going to be his natural self. So we'll save this for later. Maybe he'll look like this inside this psychedelic dungeon. So we'll work with this kind of art right here. He'll look, yeah, he might as well just look like that. So when he's idling, lips. Right, that could work too, cash hit. Yeah. And I think it's gonna really help when I get in when the player is in a totally different dungeon. The psychedelic dungeon, I'm gonna play around with the art a lot. It might not look realistic at all. It might look totally tie-dyed, who knows? Or it might be totally black. We'll see. So we'll see what works inside that kind of dungeon. But for now, I'm gonna just draw this guy. I think next thing I'm gonna work on this stream is to do a mock-up piece of art for that psychedelic dungeon, and that would be where he would fit with those colors a lot better. All right, there we go. So when he's idling, does he breathe? Maybe he. Maybe his shoulders go down a little bit. Or up, yeah, up would work better. Okay, let's see what this animation looks like with him just breathing. That didn't look right, did it? No. This needed his whole shoulders to move. Oh, same thing with the bottom here. I don't know. I don't like that. It's not really working. Maybe just looks and left and right. We could do another one where he's facing the other way. That could do. All right. Can render that out. Oops, turn off the gray background, of course. I might need shadow offset a little bit different too. He's like, no, no, turn around, go, see ya, no, nope, can't come this way. Yeah, some slight movement in his cloth for sure. You shall not pass. You shall not pass. Yeah, definitely some slight movement for sure. Good call. That would really help. So as he looks to the left, this front bit of his cloth would move a little bit to the left as well. It's not slight enough. Still a little bit too much. Awesome, man. All right, not bad. And I think the next thing to do would be to make him so he gets loaded from this other function I have that loads totally from the profile rather than creating everything manually. Looks like I didn't export it right. What did I do wrong? Oh, there. And in here, I think we can use create AI. Yes, he's alive. His parent, no parent. Index 0, intelligence 1, difficulty 1, item probability 1. Think that's all we need to do. We might have to push back that into the entities because that creates an AI. Does this create AI function? Is that a static or? Oh, it's not. Great. Now, does it? Oh, it does push back the entity. Okay, so there's no need. Perfect. Great. We don't need to do anything except for call that. See if that works. This is way better because then I can actually specify like his offset of his shadow. Everything will be loaded from his profile rather than having to manually create it like this, which is just dumb. Same thing with the squirrel. I should be using that. Oh, he came to life. He's not running his idle animation. That's set up right. It's got two animations. Wonder why he's not doing the idle. Maybe if we give him some behavior, he might actually start doing something. So, Sentinel is a pretty easy behavior. Just walks left and right. He doesn't have a walking animation yet, but we'll give him one here in a sec. Ah, he disappeared. Oh, he turned into a squirrel. That's funny. All right, yeah, so we got to give him the right input allowed. Allow input east, west. And we need to make him, at least give him the Akiyu's version of idling. That's hilarious. Okay, next let's give him a shadow offset. Think it's shadow offset. I'm not sure what that keyword is. Shadow offset. That it? No, it's not it. Is it shadow Y? Oh, there it is, shadow Y. Yeah, there we go. Now his shadow is 1 pixel up, so that looks better. Next, let's get him to actually look right when he's walking. Yeah, make him moonwalk. Oh, that's such a good idea. Right, hang on, guys. Let me be right back. Get a drink of water. Man, believe it or not, I gotta sit down today. Gotta move all this schwiz out of That's better, much better. What's up, Azarus? I'm making this guy called the Kiyu here. He's the yeah, it's a poster. You guys seen this before? This is the poster from the Kickstarter. Yeah. I took it and I put it on a. I built a canvas, so I just made a canvas frame out of some wood, and then I like stapled the poster on, so it makes it kind of 3D, and it doesn't fall off the, doesn't like you know fall off the wall like some posters tend to do, you know, when you like you put them on the wall. Yeah, sure. I can show you the workspace. Let me turn around the camera here. You'll get the idea what this room's like. It's just a tiny room, a few instruments, and over there. I don't know if you can see it, but there's my suitcase drum set. I don't have it set up, but I got most of my drums in there, so I usually take that to parties or I go to parks and play my drums and stuff. So this is my work room. All right, so the next thing, let's get him to animate correctly. Oh, one thing he wasn't doing was his Create AI wasn't doing. Nice. I'm glad you like the poster. Yeah. I think that during the Kickstarter, like around 15 people got this poster, and then three people even got it with the signed version. So there's a few of these out there. Maybe one point I'll do another poster for sale or something like that, but like before the game launches or something. I'll do a totally different image. Oh yeah, so when it creates this AI, he's an NPC. We don't want him to come to life like the other enemies do. So that's gonna be part of his collision category. So when it creates, here we go, entrance style. This is only applied to foes. Oops. And then we'll get him to walk. Right now he just looks he looks really weird because he's not walking. Yeah. But it's a couple steps better. Right now he's actually he's got his shadow right and he doesn't sleep like other enemies do. All right, that's how you see, man. Good luck with Java. Good night, man. All right, so the first thing to get him walking would be east. So we'll start with an east animation. Yeah, idle east. Okay. So when he's facing east, he's gonna be have his horns and everything facing a completely different direction. We don't need to store all this other stuff for now. Good word is on room generation, sort of. You're not talking about world generation, but you're talking about actual just inside a room generation. Yeah, so the guy that made Lena's Inception, Tom Coxon, has some good articles, not only on overworld procedural generation, but actually on the actual rooms, what goes inside each room. Ooh. Yeah, so were you asking about actual whole dungeons, or are you talking about rooms inside dungeons? Cool. I think this is the room styling here. Oh, but dungeons, but like a house. I get you. Okay, well then, yeah. Sorry, then you'd probably, yeah, check out these. MetaZelda, he's got some great articles on all of that. Not only on how to generate dungeons, but how to generate rooms in dungeons. So either whatever you're looking for, I'm pretty sure that would help. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Oh, Asmerus, yeah, you were asking what I'm doing. I finished the animation yesterday, so you were here doing some of that. I was animating the player, dipping his cup into this fountain thing here. So here's how that animation turned out. And now I'm working on this guy is actually going to be your spirit guide. So when you eat the cactuses, you'll see him at the edge of the screen. He like starts appearing and he starts guiding you towards these fountains. Up inside the secret in optional dungeons. So yeah, just working on the guy he's your spirit guide, basically. This guy is your spirit guide. What up, Lime Studios? Howdy, howdy, howdy. What up, Sferk? How's it going, guys? What's up, PMC? He looks devious. Nice. Cool. I'm glad he looks devious. He's supposed to look ambiguous. Like, is he on your side? Is he not? I think the front of him is a little bit. Yeah, I'm pretty. There's got to be some people here in those C sharp. That's better. Better perspective. Yes. We gotta get this other one open for reference, the south one. I think I might simplify this art a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna simplify this. Yeah, this guy's colors could be simpler.
So I had too many colors before with this guy. Yeah, better. Simpler, simple, simple. It's always so good. Be simple. Oh, wait, I do have another color here I could use, though. And what if he gets a little more color depth too? So as he gets, as this color gets a little deeper red. Yeah, I like that. Let's play with his palette a bit. So this darker color here is also going to be a little more red. Yeah, nice. That's cool too. Nice. Improved. What's up, Weetabit? Awesome, man. What game are you working on again right now? Yeah. Huh. I mean, what about PMC? What about just doing some Unity tutorials? I mean, doesn't Unity, usually a Unity tutorial will teach you some C sharp a little bit, right? Nice, man. It reminds me of Tiny Tower, kind of. I like it. I think maybe the only place you could maybe touch up a little maybe is this lower part of his face here, or this darker part of his face maybe. I'm not sure how you would work on it there. Maybe make it a little darker on his face, or I don't know. But all in all, it looks really fun, and it looks like you got it kind of a good aesthetic going for your game. Yeah, seeing it animated would really help too. Cause you never sometimes when you see it just still frames, you don't really kind of get the whole feeling until you really see it animated, you know? Awesome, man. Yeah. Me too. I've been told this is the WTF approach. Damn, I messed up this guy's art. But it looks better. I want to keep on this old train. Yes, definitely. Yeah, probably just best to redo this whole animation, actually. Now that he's got better colors. All your placeholder variable names are... That's so great. No, they're a little bit different. Yeah. They're slightly different when he turned. But it was really simple to create, so I'm just going to create it again. All I did was just barely edit this bit of his cloak here. Looks like it just barely moves. Yeah, that's all right. Oops. Yeah, I know. Some people, yeah. Definitely, definitely, definitely. It's just haters, dude. It's trolls and haters. And once again, they're just like, it sucks to get those kind of comments from haters and trolls and people that are just saying stupid stuff like this. But man, the sooner you get those kind of comments on your art, the better, because you got to learn to get over it, you know? So, and you got to focus on the positive. Usually you're going to get way more positive comments than you're going to get negative. So, you know, just got to kind of deal with it, you know? What's up, drunk chimpanzee? Yeah, I'm making a guy that's your spirit guide, and he guides you to the place where you drink from the fountain. So he's in the game sort of right now, and I'm working on the art for him, just to be better. Right now he starts moonwalking and stuff up there. But yeah, he's gonna appear at the edge of the screen, especially when you take your cactuses. So you eat cactuses, and you trip out and you get these psychedelic powers. But when you're under the influence of the cactus, that's when you're gonna first start seeing him. And so he appears and he like walks and starts guiding you towards these fountains where you can drink from the fountain using your red cup. And that takes you to these optional secret dungeons. So this is where you would drink and boom, the screen would fade to black here and you'd wake up in the secret dungeon. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Yeah, thick skin, exactly. You really do gotta have thick skin being a game developer, because you're gonna get those trolls. You know, it doesn't matter how good your game is. You're always gonna get some percentage of haters. And, you know, we could theorize forever on what their motives are, but in the end, you just got to learn how to have thick skin. Because they're not going to go away. There's always going to be haters. That's not bad. I'm thinking his eye color might change too. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, me too. Me too. I mean, I haven't done 3D art, but I still prefer it. I don't know why. But who are they, right? I don't know. Who are they? Mm-hmm. It doesn't. It really doesn't matter. What does matter is the people that say positive comments. Those people matter. Those are the ones you're writing the game for. You know what I mean? You're not writing the game for the haters. Your game is not meant to be played by haters. Your game is meant to be played by the people that's their genre. That's their thing. You know, that's like, this is their jam. You know, this is the best game that they could ever possibly imagine playing. That's the kind of people that you're looking for. And that they're looking for you too. People, it's not just your responsibility to share your game. It's a mutual thing. You know, you share your game as much as you can, but you also need to keep that in mind that some people are just going to find you, you know? Thanks, Marza. My skin's already thicker. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They hate us because they hate us. Dude, that's so funny. I saw that movie. Yeah. Yeah, that was a good movie. Yeah, yeah, totally. Totally. And it helps to talk about it too, right? It helps to talk about it, you know, amongst us creators of stuff. You know, it's like, it's good to talk about this kind of stuff because, you know, then you can kind of talk out any negative issues you might have had. And it's good to have that support of us, because we know, we all can relate in this matter, you know? So I already did this animation, but I'm redoing it because I changed his color depth of this guy a little bit. So he's a little bit higher quality. Yeah, you do. Yeah, totally. Yeah, and yeah, it helps to know that other people are getting it too, right? You don't like the programmer's location? It's weird, right? Where am I? What is this? Yeah, my skin is so thick now. It's just bouncing right off me. Thanks, guys. Yeah. Oh, I am. I'm in the same room. Yeah. You ABC Warriors? Too far, too far. Yeah, so like this little closet right here is where I normally stream, right? I'm my computer's normally in the top of that, and I got my laptop and everything, or my keyboard here, and then the rest of this room is just like, you know, what you normally see. This is the room that I'm normally in and everything. I'm just sitting down today because I'm tired. I'm lazy. So gotta sit my ass down for a minute. You hate to hate? What are you hating for if you hate to hate? All right, cool. All right, redo this animation. Now I like it better. I like the color depth of him better. And he's simpler. He only has like three or like four different shades of this brown. Yeah, the tour. This is the tour of the room. Yes, yeah. Yes. I've come out of the closet today. Today I'm out of the closet. But tomorrow I'll be back in the closet. You can't wait for the mansion tour? If I had the money to actually buy my own house or whatever, I would build my own, and I would build sort of a small house. It wouldn't really be a mansion, but we can call it a mansion. We would definitely call it some kind of mansion, for sure. Wiz Cribs. Yeah, this is where the magic happens right here. Oh, with hope, yes, with hope. I was looking at Steam Spy. Have you guys seen Steam Spy? You've probably heard of Steam Spy, but it's you can go on and you can look at approximately how many people own a game on Steam, and you can't really generate this into actual income because sometimes the games are on sale or whatever. But I found out that like some people I know, I'm like, oh, this is how many copies of their game they sold, like Legend of Dungeon. I've worked with these guys before, Robot Loves Kitty. They have 200,000 people that own this game. You know, no wonder they were hiring a while ago. Axiom Verge, I was very surprised at how few people actually own it. There's only 24,000 people that own Axiom Verge on Steam, but of course it was released on PlayStation 4 first, so it's more of a PlayStation game. It's got to be zombie proof. Right? You like that challenge? Is it fun? Yeah, what's some other interesting ones to look up? Oh, look at how much Prison Architect. I'm really surprised by this game because if you look at the graphics for Prison Architect, they're not that great. But still, it's an amazingly, look at how amazingly successful this game is. 1.5 million people own it. But anyways, yeah, Steam Spy is pretty neat. Yeah, nice. Oh, Nuclear Throne. I didn't even think to look at that up. Sorry, that was my fault. I'm calling this one my fault. I was asking questions whilst BC Warrioring. So wrong of me. How much did nuclear throw into you, huh? Whoa, only 150? That's surprising, too. I would have thought more people owned this game. Wow, see? You got to keep this in perspective. No, don't kick in. There's no rabbits. Kingdom, right? Kingdom's brand new, and it's already... I looked this up yesterday or whatever. Kingdom already has what? Wait, where'd it go? Kingdom. Oh my god, I didn't know Kingdom Rush was on Steam as well. I saw this yesterday. Where's the latest Kingdom? There's so many games with the word Kingdom. Here we go. Yeah, 60,000 people already own it. And that's since October 21st, which was what? 2 weeks ago? 3 weeks ago, max? Already 60,000 people own this game? They're kicking ass. Totally. Yeah, it did. Yeah, is that why? Yeah, for which one? It is. Yeah. Yeah, they probably are. You know, and every one of these, I'm sure they, you know, what's cool about this game is it has a unique concept, of course. It's like a side scroller, but you build stuff. So I'm sure that hook really helps them. Yeah, they must be. They're not only are they that popular on Steam, but I think they just launched on consoles, or they're about to launch on consoles this next year or something like that. Yeah, definitely. Oh, right. Yeah, it also depends on how long a game is already, you know, if it's out or if it's early access or what. Okay, good. We got this one done. Let's get this side done now. I know. It's right. That really surprises me too. It's like, how are they so successful? How do 1 million people own a game when it's 27 euros, $30 my price or whatever? But yeah, $30 around. That's a lot to pay for an indie game or a game on Steam. You know, it's a good question. I don't know if it's actually been officially released yet. Yeah, it is. It's expensive. You did? Oh, maybe that's why so many people own it then. Maybe it's most people bought it when it was cheaper. Oh yeah, that's another one to check out too. Binding of Isaac, right? I looked this one up too. Binding of Isaac's what? It's like 3 million people own it or something. It's mega successful. But it's also way cheaper. It's like a lot less expensive than, almost 3 million people own it. And I know it's been on, oh, this is the old school, this is the original. Here's the remake. Still, 1 million people own it. And it's a lot higher priced. So yeah, they're kicking ass for sure. Super Meat Boy. Yeah, Ed McMillan is doing quite well, I'm sure. Yeah, Super Meat Boy, 2.25 million. Right? That means that even if they're only making $5 on average per copy of Super Meat Boy that's been sold just on Steam, that's still $10 million they've made on that game. And only two people made it. Megasphere? Megasphere's not out yet, though. Megasphere is still demoed, right? Is that right? Maybe it is out. Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, damn. Yeah, not many people own it yet. He's also released a demo of his game, which I'm kind of on the fence. Like, should you release a demo or not? I don't know. Because it's like fulfillment, you know? It's like you give people a demo of your game. Are they really going to buy the full version? Because they're going to get a taste of your game and they're going to find out if it sucks or not, you know, or if it's not their thing or not, you know. Regardless, Megasphere has amazing graphics, but I wasn't really too much of a fan of the game after I played it because I didn't like the gameplay. I wished it was more of like Super Nintendo style, Metroid style controls, but it was way dual stick shooter type game, so... He failed though? I don't know. I think he's still just in he might be, yeah, he might be considering that a failure. I don't know, but who knows. All right, Lime, see you, man. Is it? I don't know. That's a good question. What is he going to say about Songbringer? It's not even on, whoops. It's not even on early access yet, so I doubt it's even on here. Oh, look. Wow. It is on here. And it says that 500 people own it already. Which is wrong. I'm pretty sure that's wrong. Because I don't think there's 500 people that have gotten codes yet. Unless they have some crazy way to hack the system. And it's already been hacked or something like that. But yeah, I think that's probably just wrong. And it's not free. That's wrong too. Oh well. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 exactly. Neo Zoo. And it's such a great looking game too, you know? Yeah, yeah. Did they really do a video on demos? That would be a good one to watch. Actually, I should look that up. Demo days. Cool. I'll check this out later. This would be a good one to check out for sure. Yeah. Right. Remember those? Oh, how did Songbringer get? Songbringer has from people that pre-ordered the game on the Kickstarter and pre-ordered from the Humble Bundle. So they're getting alpha access essentially. It's not even early access. It's before that, right? I know, plus or minus 1,000. You're pretty smart if you could do that, right? Negative. Good man. I'm glad. Yeah. What have I done today? All I've done is been, I'm drawing your spirit guide. This guy is your spirit guide. He guides you to these dungeons where you drink from the fountain. So he basically guides you to the fountain. And then inside this secret dungeon or whatever, it's going to be all psychedelic and weird, or maybe dark. I'm not sure if it'll be dark or psychedelic, so I'm going to draw a mock-up or whatever. But he looks crazy weird right now because he's moonwalking. But yeah. I'm working on him, so I'm making an eastward facing animation of him walking now. NeoZoo, I'm self-taught. I learned from books. Yeah, I learned a long time ago to code with C. 20 years ago, I learned C and then C++ and stuff. So, yeah, I know I need to talk less. Sorry, talk amongst yourselves. I'll just draw for a moment. Sorry, I get rambly. I'm passionate about making games, you know? Oh, wait a minute. Let's merge these layers so I'm not confused. I think he has two of these stripe things coming down. Yeah, he's got one on this side, so we'll keep that. Probably not. It's, you know, making games takes time no matter what. It doesn't really matter if you take a break and talk for a while. That looks, Yeah. Wait a minute, what happened to this? This is totally the wrong color. There. Whoops. Ah, man, so much better with this, the slight color changes. Yeah. It's a UFO. What's the name? I don't know. I don't know what this guy's name is yet. So if anybody has an idea, if you have an idea for this guy's name, please shout it out right now. Tell me what you want, what this guy should be named, because I've come up with the name Akiyu, but I don't like Akiyu. He needs a better name than Akiyu. There, better color depth, yay! Spirit Foo? Call him PMC for life? Atreyu? Turbo? No, Steam keeps 30. Usually. Around. Dragonborn, that's kind of interesting. Nico? Bramble? Interesting. Pikachu, hilarious. Jar Jar Binks, of course, hilarious. But I couldn't live with myself if I named anything Jar Jar, unless it was an Easter egg character. I'd probably commit suicide. I'd be like, oh no, that's it. I have to go commit Harakiri, or what is it? Harakiri? What's that called where they kill themselves with their sword? This one little, this bit is a little wrong here. There. That's better. Okay, cool. Cool. Ready to animate him now. Ah. There. Maybe be a cut. Right, animation time. Spiritborn. Interesting. Is Harakiri, right? Morris? Right? Like as in Steve, the one who should Oh, that was the palette. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna do a simple animation where it's just four frames. Like, we know 1 foot forward, and then the other frame is the other foot forward. So, this first one. Yeah, we'll rotate his, we'll put his left foot forward in this frame. Of course, man, yeah. Thornak. Weedle. Spirit Weaver. Seppuku, is that, that's the name? Bob Ross, you playing in disguise? Okay. Nice, man. You're looking good. I like your shading and everything. It's cool. Yeah. I mean, you know, all you really need at this point is some texturing maybe on this rock. You don't even want texturing on it, though. You like Thornak too? All right, we got two votes for Thornak. Falkenhauf. Panzer. What does that name mean again, Panzer? Solo. I kind of like that. I kind of like the name Solo. Is it two Star Wars though? Well, we got three votes for Thornak. Interesting. Pantomime. Houndman. Brumler. Hero. Hmm. Ooh, maybe all the names. Bob Solo. DMX. You vote for PMC? That is three. Lone. Hmm. Hmm, okay. This guy's kind of a weird animation for him walking because you can't really see his feet, so I don't know how this is gonna... It should be easier, right? Technically. But, yeah. And add Sanic. Yeah. Yeah, right? Down to Earth name. Just like the Solo cup, it's its own It's like juxtaposed. All right, so this frame, he gets even more. Ralph Solo. Is it Rock's father? If it was, I wouldn't tell you guys at this point, but I'm not sure if I know what the hell's going on yet, what these gonna be. But I want him to be surprising. I definitely want him to be a surprise. Like, you're like, what? But that would be so... It'd be awesome, but it would be so Star Wars, you know? I wonder what this is going to look like. Does that even look like movement? I'm not so sure. I think that might be at least a bit too much going on with the front of his... Whatever the hell you call that he's wearing. Character name generator. Ooh, let's see what happens. Horny man. Chessy? Oh, now that's interesting. Maybe he doesn't technically even have a name. That's kind of cool. It's Rock's sister. And maybe it's a girl. Yeah. Oh, now that's interesting too, Ezra's. He's not actually there. Yeah, more movement. Mm-hmm. Whatchamacallit. Sherry Powell. Hi, me Tom. Dude, this is crazy. It gives you like a personality breakdown. Wait, we already did this one. Right? No name? That's kind of interesting. Thong lulls. Ooh, an Indian name is kind of interesting. Nora Chicken. I don't even know how to say that. Extrovert sensing, thinking, judging. Choose male. Wikipedia Turner. Laith Islam. It's kind of interesting to have a name, a last name that's like a religion. All right, see you, PMC. 20 minutes later. Sorry. Ebenezer Paskowitz. This might be all right. This might be on the right track here with these four frames. We'll see what that looks like when he's actually walking in the game now. Man, looks like I've used up the whole stream just drawing him. I was gonna try and do a whole dungeon mock-up art today too. Guess I might have to save that for tomorrow. It's already getting dark in here. Ah, what's up? Why is he... Oh, because I didn't change the art yet. I didn't change the profile. Knackthorn. Up and down? Yeah. Oh, maybe he should move his shoulders or his... Yeah. Oh, wait, this isn't idle. This is not idle. This is walking. Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. Okay, let's take off that cloak flick a bit in the back there. Try a little bit of up and down. Actually, okay, wait, when you got your feet extended, yeah, you should be down on the other one, the other frame. This frame, let's try them down a pixel. Yeah, it definitely looks more like walking now for sure. Maybe still a little bit too much going on with the cloak in the back and the front. Such a big cloak, it would probably cover up most of that. Maybe this one too, a little less. Thanks, Tobar. Cheers, man. Yeah, that up and down motion really, really helped it. And then, yeah, this one right here still, I think, has too much. Maybe just like that. Yeah, that actually is looking a lot better. But maybe a little bit more of this going on up here in this top corner. Make this look a little, yeah. Yeah, cool. I'm liking that. All right, let's try it out. Oops, wrong export. There's two exports in this thing. You don't know which one to use. It's like his shoulders go out on the fourth frame. Oh, is there a problem with that? I don't know. Welcome to the stream today, GNZ, by the way. His shoulders go out on the fourth frame? Like it's wrong looking or good looking? He's moving too fast for, you know, he's should be more calm. Like he's a spirity, mystical guy. And I think his delay can be a little bit less per frame too. What's up, Lith? I want to see him walk longer. Let's do. It's going good, man. Oh, you like that fourth frame? Okay. Yeah, with him moving slower, that really helps too. But I think you should move even slower. Like I'm imagining you see him on the edge of the screen and you have no controls for a minute. Like you're like, what? It goes into story mode almost or something. Nice. Okay, that's a bit too slow. Yeah, he's kind of like, here I come, bitches. He's got like a definite like, swagger going on. I love that. This guy's making me laugh. Oh, development's going great, man. Lith, yeah, so since you've watched, there's four new enemies. There's this whole thing with the drinking from the fountain. I'll show you the drinking. You like that speed? Nice. You liked it at slower, like 15? Let's see what it's like at 20. Yeah, see, it's still pretty slow at 20. But maybe 15 would be better for some situations. So, Lith, there's gonna be these like optional dungeons. You have to have the red cup to get in here, these dungeons. And this guy up here in the top right, or the guy that you're seeing swagger around like that, he's your spirit guide. You start seeing him when you take the cactuses and you start tripping out and you see him at the edge of your screen, you're like, whoa, and he starts guiding you towards these fountains. And then when you drink from the fountain, sorry, you can actually walk on top of the fountains right now because they're not finished yet. So come on. Put your sword away so we can use the cup. There's still a lot left I have to do to get the behaviors for all of this working right, but I'm just more in the art zone lately. But so there's where you drink from the fountain and you fall over. So right here, the screen will fade to black and you'll be inside this psychedelic or dark world or something. I'm not sure what it'll look like. And then you'll find him inside this optional dungeon and he teaches you some skill. For example, you might have, what's this one? Here, let's use the dash attack skill. This is a dash attack. You charge forward and you attack at the same time. So that's one skill. It's like a chi skill or a bioenergy skill or a mystical skill. It's like you're almost like you're a Jedi. It's kind of borrowing from Star Wars, I guess. He does walk like a boss. It's three kids stacked on top of each other. I like it. Swagthorn. Call him Swagger. He's riding a mini bicycle. Will it? How does animation work in game development? It depends on what kind of game you're creating. But for pixel art, you just create each frame of your pixel art separately. And then, at least in this, the way I'm doing it in this game, I create each frame separately, right? Like, here's one frame, here's another frame, here's another frame, here's another frame. There's four frames in this animation. All four of these frames get exported as separate PNG files, and then they all get compiled into one big texture file where they can be referenced again in the game. So this really helps your texture memory, right? Like, here's all of the enemy and NPC and hero sprites in the game so far. So there's a hell of a lot of sprites, and they all get packed into one bit of texture memory, so it's way more efficient for your GPU. Is Minecraft pixel? Nah. Well, it's voxel, so it's sort of. Oh, these things are going to be funny to translate? Oh my gosh. I haven't even thought about what it will be like to translate this. All right, cool. We got them walking east and west. Let's get them walking north and south. That shouldn't be too hard. Famous last words. South. We got a good south-facing animation. Now let's make this... and also he might be psychedelic. See, he might look like that during this in the psychedelic dungeons. We'll see. I kind of like this. It's kind of fun. But it doesn't really work for the overworld, right? We tried early in the stream putting him like that in the game, and it's just too bright. The aura is kind of a cool idea, adding this aura. And it would be neat to add a sway or glow or pulsate or something like that. But yeah, that's definitely going to have to be inside the psychedelic dungeon for it to fit. All right, see you, Tom. Good night, man. Did you make him actually trip? Nice. All right, cool. I'm going to do a southward facing walking animation from now, and then a northward facing, and then I think that's gonna be it for him for now. It's gonna be fun to actually get him in the dungeon, you know, in this new kind of dungeon, whatever this is. Also in this secret dungeon or whatever, I'm thinking that Jib does not come with you, so I would love some thoughts on that. What you know, because like, the one drawback to that is that if you're playing co-op and your friend is playing as Jib, then inside these secret dungeons or these optional dungeons, then your friend is not playing with you. So it's like, does Jib come with you or does Jib not? I don't know. I kind of think it would be interesting to It would be interesting to play without Jib. It would actually be very interesting from a single player perspective to not have Jib for a few dungeons. So, but I'm definitely looking for some thoughts on that, if anybody has anything you want to contribute there. Jib is the spirit guide. Oh no, that's a really crazy twist, right? You get there and Jib reveals that a drone is controlling this guy, and that Jib has been controlling the drone all along. Oh my god, that's kind of a crazy plot twist. I don't know. Yeah, see you, Pedro. Good night, man. Yeah, Spirit Foo says goodbye. See ya. Good night, good night. Oh man, this run animation south is almost done already. Yeah. I love both these ideas. I like this. You know, that... either he's totally imaginary, or Or he's some kind of crazy plot twist. Good ideas, you guys. I'm going to have to think about this for a while. Is it dark? Yeah, maybe I'll turn on the light. Oh, right. Yeah, that's an idea, Thief.
Yeah, let me get the light on in here. Hold on. Right. Oh, chimpanzee? Yeah, that's another good reason to do that. Your friend would play as this guy. Interesting. Right, this is so almost done. All I gotta do is make this frame where he's stepping down. Huh, I don't know, man. I haven't made a game with JavaScript myself. I haven't even heard of Phaser. Maybe somebody else has, though, here. Oh, yeah, he's walking super fast now. Party! Yeah! This is what happens when you eat the cocoa leaves. Don't eat the cocoa leaves too much. Actually, I think this might actually be done though. Seriously, that's all it really needs. You should be my coworker. Make it blue and call him Sanic, that's all you gotta do. Run south. Add this run south animation. Okay, so now he can walk south as well. Let's see what happens when he randomly turns. Why aren't you walking south, man? Oh. Oh, I just noticed that the cactus is not the right Z, so he's walking on top of the cactus. I think that'll work, the animation. Yeah, it's kind of cool, right? Especially when this game's all said and done, too, it'll be bigger and more massive. So that'll be kind of interesting to finally look back at it all and see, like, oh, look, this is all the sprites that make up this game. We're almost ready for this north. Ooh. Oh, now that's interesting.
What's scary about him? All right, thief, see, man. It's late for y'all. It's getting late for me. It's even getting dark out. Oh, damn, that sucks. Really? Corrupted sprite cheese would be hella hard to fix. Nice, good. I like it. I like it. I like it. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. I have both. I have the SNES controller and the Xbox, and I definitely prefer the SNES. It's just like the Xbox is a little too heavy. I don't know what. I guess I just didn't really grow up using it an Xbox type controller. I grew up with the SNES, so yeah, the SNES just feels more right to me. Okay, now let's just do the other animations. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah. Okay, so he's going upwards on these next frames. So, duplicate that. Make this layer. He goes up a frame. Or up pixel. Yeah? Yeah, yeah. Well, yeah, with Axiom Verge, you've got to play it with a 360 controller because there's so many freaking buttons. There's like every single button on the Xbox controller is used by Axiom Verge. Yeah, you did? Nice, dude, nice. I did for a second. He was cut in half. He was halved. Mm. Okay, so but anyways, this little animation needs a little bit of movement going on in the cloak. So when he looks this way, this all shifts a little to the right. And this one, it all shifts a little to the left. What's so good about it? Yeah. It's like Metroid. If you like Metroid or anything, and if you like the old school, the 2D Metroid games, you're gonna love Axiom Verge. You just guaranteed. If you have any love for Metroid, you're gonna love Axiom Verge. I honestly think it's better than Super Metroid, better than the old ones. It's really good. Which is why I'm so surprised that it doesn't have as many sales as I would expect. But still, 20,000 sales of a video game is quite decent. And who knows, Steam Spy might be wrong. Oh yeah, jam in. Yeah, true, Neo Zoom. I think that's a really big part of it, is that it's so high priced. Yeah, I agree. I totally agree. If it was 15, it would be better. 12 would probably be even better, you're right. Yeah, I was too, I gotta admit. I held off for months. I was like, no, I'm not gonna buy Axiom Verge, it's 20 bucks. But then I finally gave in. I'm like, you know what? I have a good feeling this is going to be a great game, so I might as well just buy it. So I'm glad I did. But still, I would have purchased it a lot earlier had it been even $5 cheaper. Yeah, the wall jumping was difficult for sure. Marley Bob. Is this game coming out on Pirate Bay? I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what happens with that. I'm sure it'll get pirated at some point. If I'm lucky, you know, that's kind of a good sign that your game's succeeding if somebody's pirating it. Yeah, it's a little too steep, right? 20 bucks. For an indie pixel art game, you know, yeah, it's all, y'all, you gotta keep it in perspective or whatever. Which is why I'm so surprised that Prison Architect is so expensive. It's like, it really doesn't seem to have the art quality that you would pay for a $30 game. Or nor the gameplay. I'm not really that impressed with the gameplay from Prison Architect to pay 30 bucks for it. So I'm really surprised by that one. All right, let's render Run North here. And we can add northward movement and Run North. Yeah, that auto-delete your save. why is he walking right through me? What's up? Dude. Oh, he's got the wrong move mask, that's it. Song printer. Nice, man. Cool. I'm glad. How long is the stream so far? Yeah, I wish I had Nightbot. I don't have Nightbot.
I'm too lazy to put on Nightbot every time. So far, oh my god, 2.5 hours again. Damn. I do gotta get going. 2.5 hour stream again. There you go. No, it's 420. Yeah, it's 420 by 240, I think, is my current res. But it's gonna be different. It's gonna be a little different on like iPad or whatever. But yeah, it's based on 256 pixels tall from Nintendo's era. You know? I based it on that, just made it a little more widescreen. I know. Yeah. Okay, but let's get him so he doesn't walk on the player at least first, right? Move, collision. Oh, let's make him a collision neutral, I guess. Collision none. Move. Okay, we need a move component that makes him so he can't walk on. Move. Oh, there's one. .3.3 move. This is where his collision is what he collides with. So he at least collides with friend, static, exit, this kind of stuff. I gotta go. I gotta get dinner. We got plans tonight. But that's a pretty long stream, huh? 2.5 hours? There. Why didn't you turn north? Dude, you would love turning north, man. It's so nice. There you go, south. He walks too fast. Look at him. He's like hopping. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I like going north to south. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. Why is he so fast and bouncy? Seriously, it was the same delay. Wait a minute, did it? Yeah, why are they? What are the Raven and the Squirrel even doing? Squirrel, I gotta upgrade his AI for sure. What did I do? I said it. Huh, that was weird. Yeah, I do gotta get going. I do gotta get going for sure. I'll fix this later. So anyways, yeah. So to recap what got done today. Stranger danger. Yeah, good evening, you guys. It was so great hanging with you. As always, thanks for watching and stuff. But yeah, so what got done today, if anybody's just joined or whatever, I'm working on this spirit guide guy. This guy will guide you towards these psychedelic fountains where you drink and you wake up in this psychedelic world and fight this guy and learn crazy abilities and stuff. So yeah, that's it for today's stream, and I'll be back later, probably tomorrow.